Hey, hi, welcome back to Digit.in. My name is Vignesh. Now let's talk about you. Are you that sort of a buyer who looks at a MacBook and thinks, wow, I mean, I really like the finish on that thing. It's nice. I wish Windows laptops came in such forms because you see, you're really set in your own Windows ways and you really can't part with it because all your applications run on it and you really prefer Windows. Are you that sort of buyer? Because if you are, the laptop we've got for you today will be quite suitable. It's the Surface laptop by Microsoft and it's quite nice. Let's take a look at it in this review, shall we? Let's check out the build and design of the Surface laptop. The aluminium cover looks like a clean slate with a tiny mirror in the middle. The back is almost equally bare if you leave out the tiny round rubber feet on all four corners. Like the MacBook Air, the Surface laptop's base tapers towards the front. The laptop feels grippy to hold in the hands. What's refreshing about the Surface laptop is that it's extremely light to carry. Its 1.2 kilogram body feels equally weighted on all sides and doesn't feel heavy on any one side. As advertised by Microsoft, the Surface laptop can be opened with a single finger while it rests on a table. This quality about the laptop is a big factor for those who are using it constantly in meeting rooms and in conference rooms and in cafes. All this is also a testament to Microsoft's thoughtful design. The lid is easy to open and stays firmly in its place even when the laptop is shaken about a bit. What's a disappointment for me is that the lid does not open beyond 135 degrees, because a lid that folds all the way back, that is 180 degrees, is more convenient for odd working positions. Also, it hinders flexibility while using the touchscreen, especially with a Surface Pen stylus. Pushing the lid back beyond its limit on one side reveals some flex on the surface of the lid. It's a little scary to watch, but the lid shouldn't really crack unless you intend to damage the thing. The inside of the lid contains a laser-cut glass, which, according to Microsoft, is not mass-produced for reasons of quality. A piano black bezel of about half an inch surrounds the 13.5-inch display and lends the laptop a very classy look. The area around the keyboard and the touchpad is made of Alcantara, a durable microfiber material that's also spill-proof. All in all, the build of the Surface laptop is promising, even if there are some signs of flex on the lid and the keyboard. This laptop should survive scratches and, with any luck, the occasional fall as well. The Surface laptop has only one display option, a 13.5-inch PixelSense touchscreen unit. The aspect ratio is the more traditional 3:2, and the pixel density is a comfortable 201 pixels per inch. Colors on the Surface laptop's display are vivid and screen brightness is available in excess. Contents on the display are visible clearly in all conditions, bright or dark. The only fly in the ointment I see here is the presence of a glossy finish on the display. This makes the screen highly reflective, thus content becomes more difficult to read in certain angles. Touch response on the Surface laptop's display is quick and precise. Palm rejection works accurately while writing and drawing. To stay as thin and light as possible, the Surface laptop has lost some essential ports that could have come in handy for power users. On the left, there's a USB port, a mini display port, and a 3.5mm audio jack for headsets. On the right, there's the Surface Connect power port and nothing else. If port availability is important to you, then you might want to look away from the Surface laptop or prepare yourself to buy a bunch of fat dongles. The keyboard on the Surface laptop is one of the best features on it. Despite being flat, the keys on the keyboard are of the ideal size, softness, and have ample travel. This makes each keystroke extremely easy to register. Surprisingly, Microsoft has included the context menu key in the keyboard for easy right clicks. It's a button that's rather uncommon on the laptops of today, so it's comforting to see its return. To accommodate it, Microsoft had to remove the right side control key. This makes using key combinations on the right side of the keyboard a proper pain. You just can't have everything in life, can you? All in all, the keyboard on the Surface laptop is perfect for somebody whose job, or hobby even, involves a lot of typing. The touchpad on the Microsoft Surface laptop is a precision unit, which comes as no surprise, as it's a Microsoft product. The touchpad is neither too small nor too large. Taps, clicks, and swipes all happen smoothly and precisely. What I found a little unsettling was the fact that pressing some of the areas just around the outer perimeter of the touchpad resulted in an accidental click. Let's talk performance. The Surface laptop cuts a slightly sorry figure on the spec sheet because it features last year's Intel Core series processors, but makes up for it in real-world usage scenarios. The model I received for review had a 7th generation Intel Core i5 processor, RAM was a healthy 8GB, and storage was an acceptable 256GB. Graphics were taken care of by an integrated Intel GPU. In real-world usage, the Surface laptop's performance is quite admirable. Running 11 applications simultaneously, where one was a YouTube page playing video all the time, showed no signs of lag or judder. Switching between Windows and virtual desktops was a breeze. At no point did the animation freeze or slow down. When applications were installing, the heat under the laptop rose, but not by too much. The Surface laptop ran Metro Last Light at a pitiable 20 frames per second and Doom at an even more pitiable 11 frames per second. Clearly, the Surface laptop is no gaming machine with frame rates like that, but it definitely gets the job done when your workday poses a litany of boring spreadsheets, documents, and web pages. It's a great machine if you're into a lot of research and writing. Let's look at the battery. The laptop scored 4 hours and 12 minutes on our battery benchmark test, which is pretty decent really. During the time I had the Surface laptop, the device lasted me somewhere between 5 and 7 hours on battery power. On a 5-hour flight where airplane mode and the keyboard light were turned on, the Surface laptop lasted me the whole duration with about 40% charge left to spare. 7 hours and above is a decent figure for a laptop of this size, but not too great for a laptop of its price. All things considered, I really like a few things about the Microsoft Surface laptop. I like that it's light, I like that it's so thin, and I like that it works well above all, because performance really is MacBook level on this machine. Now, what I don't like about it is the price, because really you're paying well over a lakh rupees to get this sort of quality, which for some may actually work out. The other thing I don't like is the lack of I/O ports. You're really getting one USB here and just about nothing else. I mean, really, you've got no HDMI, no USB Type-C, nothing else, really. Well, that's it for this video and this review. I hope you liked it. I hope you enjoyed watching it. Do not forget to subscribe to our channel down below. Thank you again. Bye-bye.